स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर मुकेश शर्मा अगेन फॉर केमिस्ट्री क्लास 11 चैप्टर 1. आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज लॉज ऑफ केमिकल कॉम्बिनेशन. स्टूडेंट्स, देर आर 5 लॉज ऑफ केमिकल कॉम्बिनेशन. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑल दीज लॉज. द फर्स्ट लॉ इज द ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास. As you are seeing that what is law of conservation of mass? In general language, we can say the total mass of the reactant is always equal to the total mass of the product. It means, किसी भी chemical reaction में जो reactant का mass होता है, reactant, you know, it is always written on left hand side, then arrow. Product, that is always written on right hand side. So total mass of the reactant is always equal to the total mass of the product. For example, we take one simple reaction, Fe plus O2 arrow CO2, that is carbon plus oxygen, both are mixing together to give carbon dioxide. Students, just take the molecular masses of all the reactant and product. What is the atomic mass of carbon? It is 12. O2, the atomic mass of oxygen atom is 16. There are 2 atoms. So 2 multiplied by 16, that is 32. Carbon dioxide, carbon, it is 12 atomic mass. There are 2 atoms of carbon, so 2 multiplied by oxygen atomic mass 16. So 16, that is 12 plus 16, 2 are 32, that is 44. What it means? इसका मतलब ये है स्टूडेंट्स कि अगर कार्बन और ऑक्सीजन आपस में रिएक्शन करते हैं तो प्रोडक्ट हमारा क्या बनेगा? कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बनेगा. और कितनी कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बनेगी? अगर हम कार्बन 12 ग्राम ले लें, अगर हम ऑक्सीजन 32 ग्राम ले लें, तो टोटल हमारा मास हो जाता है 12 प्लस 32, दैट इज 44 ग्राम. और प्रोडक्ट हमारा कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड है, दैट इज 44 ग्राम. इट मीन्स 44 ग्राम हमारे रिएक्टेंट्स हैं. दैट इज डिफरेंट केस वेदर इट इज 2 और 3. आवर प्रोडक्ट whether it is 1, 2 or 3, that is different case. But the total mass of the reactants, it will always be equal to the total mass of the product. This is our first law of conservation of mass. Students, second law is law of constant composition or law of definite proportion. Law of constant proportion means whatever may be the source of preparation of a compound, whatever may be the source. For example, suppose we are to prepare carbon dioxide gas. We can prepare by burning carbon into oxygen, that is C plus O2 arrow CO2. हम CO2 को carbon के साथ में oxygen के साथ burn करेंगे तो carbon dioxide बनेगी. There may be some another ways to prepare carbon dioxide gas. For example, 2CO plus O2 arrow CO2. ये एक दूसरा तरीका है कि हम कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड से कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बनाए. Another way, CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate. अगर हम इसको HCl के साथ में रिएक्शन कराएं तो CaCl2 plus CO2 plus H2O. ये रिएक्शन हो जाती है कि हम कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट की हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड के साथ में, डाइल्यूट हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड के साथ में रिएक्शन करा रहे हैं तो कैल्शियम क्लोराइड, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड और वाटर बनेगा. अनदर वे मे बी कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट इज रिएक्टिंग विद H2SO4 सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड एंड वी विल गेट कैल्शियम सल्फेट CaSO4 प्लस कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड वाटर. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, There may be another ways also to prepare carbon dioxide gas, but carbon dioxide, we are taking carbon dioxide. So what is the ratio of carbon and oxygen? That will remain same. This is our second law of combination, that is law of definite proportion. Now see, what is the definite proportion here? Carbon, what is the atomic mass of carbon? It is 12. Oxygen, there are two atoms of oxygen, that is one atom of oxygen has 16 mass, so it will be 32. Now we can divide it by 4, 4 3 is 12, 4 8 is 32, that is carbon is to oxygen, that is equal to 3 is to 8. It means in case of carbon dioxide, the ratio of carbon and oxygen atom by mass, that is fixed, that is 3 is to 8. This is called second law of chemical combination. Now students, we come to third law of chemical combination, that is law of multiple proportion. Law of multiple proportion, what it says? It says, suppose we are having two elements, that is carbon and oxygen. So they, suppose they are forming more than one compound. For example, carbon and oxygen can form two types of compounds. One is carbon monoxide, that is CO. Another is carbon dioxide, that is CO2. Now, what is the ratio between carbon and oxygen atom in these molecules? So just see, carbon and oxygen, the first compound is carbon monoxide. So what is the atomic mass of carbon? It is 12. What is the atomic mass of oxygen? It is 16. Again, carbon 12, oxygen 16. Here are two atoms in case of CO2. So 32. If we fix the mass of one atom, it is already fixed, that is 12. Here in this case, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, the mass of one atom is already fixed, that is 12. So another 16 is to 32 in case of carbon monoxide and CO2. So the ratio of oxygen is to oxygen in CO and CO2, that is 16 is to 32. Now students, it is a simple ratio, that is 1 is to 2. So this is our law of multiple proportion. We can take another example for this. Suppose we are having nitrogen and oxygen, we have two atoms and it can form more than two compounds. For example, one is N2O, that is nitrous oxide, that is also known as laughing gas. N2O, then NO, nitric oxide, then N2O3, dinitrogen trioxide, then NO2, nitrogen dioxide, then N2O5, dinitrogen pentaoxide. These are their name. First one is N2O, that is nitrous oxide, this is also known as laughing gas, then nitric oxide, then dinitrogen trioxide, then nitrogen dioxide, and after that in the last dinitrogen pentaoxide. Now suppose we take the ratio by mass in between nitrogen and oxygen atom, then nitrogen and oxygen, we just take out nitrogen, the atomic mass is 14, so there are two atoms, that is 28. Oxygen 16, in case of nitric oxide NO, nitrogen is one atom, so 14. Oxygen is one atom, so 16. In N2O3, there are two atoms of nitrogen, so 28. There are three oxygen atoms, so 48. then nitrogen, 14, oxygen. Then N2O5, nitrogen, 28, and it is 18. If we fix the mass of one atom, so here we are seeing that in first case it is 28, in second case 14, in third case 28, so we just fix it at 28. So the second one, 28, then it will become double, that is 32. Then fourth one, it is 14, so just make it 28. It will become, because the oxygen, there are two atoms, so 16, 32, it was earlier 32, now it will become 64. Now, we have fixed the mass of one atom, that is nitrogen, as fixed, that is 28. So what is the ratio between oxygen atom of in these five oxides of nitrogen? So that is a simple ratio, just see, 16:32:48:64:80, that is 1:2:3:4:5. So now students, you understand this, this is law of multiple proportion. Now see the next one, law of reciprocal proportion. This is our fourth law of chemical combination. Law of reciprocal proportion, इसमें देखेंगे कि suppose we are having two different atoms, carbon and sulfur, and they react with any other third atom, that is oxygen. Carbon and oxygen, when these reacts together, it will form CO2. When sulfur and oxygen will react together, it will form SO2. So what is the atomic mass of oxygen? It is 16. So carbon dioxide, there are two atoms, so carbon 12, oxygen 8 16, so oxygen will have 32, because there are two atoms of oxygen. Then sulfur 32:2, there are two oxygen atoms, that is 32. And if we fix the mass of one atom, that is oxygen is already fixed, so what will be the ratio between carbon and sulfur? Between carbon and sulfur, the ratio is 12:32. So 4 3 12, 4 8 32, so it is a fixed ratio, that is 3:8. So suppose two atoms, they are combining with third atom separately, and if the one atom is fixed, then the ratio between the another two, that will be a simple ratio. This is called the law of reciprocal proportion. Now students, this is the fifth law, that is Galusak's law of combining volumes. What is the fifth law of Galusak's law? Just understand this. Galusak's law हमें ये बताता है कि अगर हमारे रिएक्टेंट और प्रोडक्ट दोनों ही गैसेस हैं, सपोज N2+3H2 → 2NH3, इन दिस रिएक्शन नाइट्रोजन इज गैस, हाइड्रोजन इज गैस, इट मींस बोथ द रिएक्टेंट्स आर गैसियस. Then product, that is ammonia, that is also a gas. So our reactants and products, all are gaseous. Then what will be the ratio between the reactants and the products? That is fixed. This is our Galusak's law. It means nitrogen, it is one volume because there is this reaction is balanced. First we have to balance it, which is already balanced. Now one volume, if we take one volume of nitrogen gas and three volume of hydrogen gas, then we will get two volume of ammonia gas. It means if we are taking 1 liter nitrogen gas, 3 liters hydrogen gas, then we will get 2 liters of ammonia gas. This is our Galusak's law, the last law of chemical combination, that is Galusak's law. So students, I hope you understand. Thank you.